So I guess here goes nothing. All right, so if you've seen any of my other videos, you've probably seen by now that I really like these 3D printed assortment boxes that I designed a while back. In fact, I like them so much that I built this entire assortment cabinet with literally hundreds of these boxes in here, as well as my drawers in my work table are full of these as well. And I really, really like these. There's just one thing. For the few times a year where I do something outside of this workshop, I would really like to be able to take a couple of these with me in a more convenient way. So in today's video, we're combining 3D printing and woodworking to make a cool little assortment case that we can take a couple of these with us in. And in addition to that, we're solving the one thing that I found to be a little bit of an issue with these boxes. You see, if I start taking a few of these out as I'm using them and working with them on my work table, and then start opening and closing these drawers, you can see that they're starting to slide all over the place. So in today's video, we're gonna fix that as well. I've got a really cool solution for how that is gonna work, so let's jump right into it and start building. So let's talk about how we're gonna solve the issue of these boxes sliding around all over the place when you have them in the drawers and especially in the box that we're gonna build. Because solving that issue is what's gonna make the rest of this build even possible. All right, so the way I've solved this is that I've designed a new type of box. Let me show you. This is the old box and this is the new box. Can you spot a difference? Well, not much of a difference with these, but let me show you this. This is the old box and this is the new box. Now you can see a difference. So the trick to stopping these from sliding around all over the place is to have some sort of feature in the bottom of them that can lock into a feature in the bottom of the drawer or a case or whatever it is. And these two features can lock together, keeping these boxes in where they're supposed to be. In my newly designed boxes, let's call these version 2, I've solved this with this grid in the bottom. And this grid is gonna lock into a place with another grid. This grid is gonna live in either the drawer or the case. And these two, nicely locked into place, keeping everything from sliding around. So this piece of grid is gonna go in the bottom, and then all the boxes have the same grid pattern feature on the bottom of them, and they will lock into place regardless of where you place them. And as long as the grid is attached to the bottom of whatever you put the boxes in, everything will stay nice and securely in place. And of course, you can go as big as you want with multiple grid pieces to make whatever size and shape you want. So I'm really excited to try this out. We'll see how well this works once we have something to put them in. For those of you wondering, yes, I'll make all these available for download. I'll have a link in that in the description below. I'll have the full range available, all the sizes that I also had in version 1. And in case you're wondering, these are backwards compatible. That means that these will fit in the same grid system as your other boxes in case you've already printed some of my previous design. The only real drawback here is that if you already printed a whole bunch of these boxes and you want a grid system in the bottom, the boxes that are bigger than 1x1s won't fit. But these will fit together with your old ones. All right, enough talk about boxes. Let's start to build something we can have these in. And for that, let's start cutting up some wood. Alright, so the woodworking part of this project is gonna be pretty simple. I've already cut all the pieces that I'm gonna need. There's 6 pieces in total, go figure, one for each side of the box. So this thing is gonna go together like this. We're gonna have a bottom, 2 sides, and a front and back. The front and back are a little lower than the sides. That is because the lid is gonna live right there in between the two higher sides. So this entire thing forms a nice and flat box. The material I'm using here is just 90mm poplar. I'm using poplar because it's really light and pretty stiff. And I think that once everything is gonna be put together, it's gonna be plenty strong. I'll assemble all this together using some glue and brad nails. So let's start turning this into a box. Alright, so now we just have to let the glue dry on this thing, which means that we can talk about today's sponsor. This week's sponsor is Skillshare. Skillshare is an amazing online learning community with literally thousands of easy to follow, premium classes with no ads in all sorts of different fields. They have classes in literally everything you've ever wanted to learn, either it's 3D modeling, video editing, or woodworking, all things that I had to go to school to learn, and you can learn from home using Skillshare. I myself just started taking a class on color grading by Fred Torino, where he goes over everything from the basics and theory behind it to the vocabulary you need and the actual grading of the footage itself. Now you can get all of this for less than $10 a month if you sign up for an annual membership. And even better than that is that the first 1,000 people to use the link in my description below will get a free trial of Skillshare Premium membership. There's only 1,000, so make sure you're quick and click that link. Go try out Skillshare Premium for free. Thank you, Skillshare, for sponsoring this video. All right, so now the glue's dry, I've just given the whole thing a quick sanding, and it's time to start assembling these pieces. We're gonna start with attaching the lid to the rest of the box, and for that, we're just gonna use some of these regular small hinges. I'll just clamp the thing together so it doesn't move on me. Now's the time to align the lid properly. All right, time to see if this works. We made a box. All right, so it's time to pimp up this box a bit. And for that, we've got a whole bunch of 3D printed parts. All these parts will do different things, but first off, let's start by making a locking mechanism for that lid so all the parts don't fall out. And the way we're gonna keep the lid from opening up on its own is with these couple of pieces. This one goes into here, and then this is a sliding mechanism that will, with the help of this hook, that goes in there, slides in place, and then this locks it in place. It will make more sense once it's installed, so let's do that. And now we have a working locking mechanism. And if you're wondering why there's such a satisfying snappy click to it, that is because there's actually two small magnets that are glued in place into these two parts that will make sure that the two plastic pieces are held in the lock position so that the stuff can't fall out once we like start moving stuff around. All right, next up is probably a handle, right? So the handle will be held in place with two of these brackets. These guys will be attached to the frame here with some screws that will go through the holes that I've already drilled in the front. And then that will go into the plastic piece and into the nut that is on the other side here. And the handle is attached with a couple of bolts that go through those brackets and into some pressed in nuts on the backside. So just like that, we've now got, I don't know, a briefcase? We're starting to get there. Next step. These things are super cool. With the extra bumpers on the corners, it gives it a lot more extra strength and some added style points. I've also added an additional little piece here to make it easier to grab onto the lid, and it doubles as a place to put some labels. So, this thing is super cool. It's like super lightweight as well. Okay, so let's start filling this thing up. As we talked about, these frames here is what's gonna allow everything to lock in place, and they will go into the bottom here like this. Oh, don't you just love when everything fits together so perfectly? And now these will lock in place. I have to say, I am super pleased with the way this thing has turned out. Everything fits really well and everything seems to be held in place really well. But let's be honest, there's only one way to really test this. And I guess that is by filling it up with some screws and then seeing what happens. All right, so this whole thing is now filled up with a bunch of random stuff. I made sure to use a bunch of the really, really small screws that I have. So I guess here goes nothing. Oh, I hope this works. What? I don't know why I'm so surprised, but it worked. There's one more test though, and that is to see if it still works if the thing isn't entirely full. And by not entirely full, I mean with just one single 1x1 container in the middle. Not gonna lie, a little bit nervous.
Hmm.
No! tell you what, this thing didn't spill anything, but I forgot to glue these in place, so everything came apart. Everything is glued in? Let's try it again. Yay! Alright, so this box is finished, and if you can't tell, I'm really happy about the way this has turned out. Alright, so we're completely done with this box, but there's still one more thing I want to do. You see, what if I all of a sudden have two boxes, and I want to take both of them with me at the same time? Wouldn't it be super convenient to have a box that these two cases go into? I agree, so let's build one. Look at that! That went pretty quick. So I made this entire frame out of the slightly thicker 12mm poplar to give it a little bit more strength than the cases themselves. I glued and brad nailed the whole thing together just like with the cases, but to give it more strength, I also screwed in some screws. And to finish everything off, I also printed these corner protectors that are very similar to the ones that I have on the assortment cases. I feel like that gives the whole thing a little bit more of a finished product look, as well as giving the whole thing a lot more rigidity. I really feel like they can take a beating now. I've also printed one more thing. Down in the bottom here, I printed and screwed on a couple of these stoppers that now allow the whole thing to securely stay in place while still being super easy to take out and put back in. So that's pretty much it. We made a case that can hold two of our assortment boxes. But there's still one thing left. I said I wanted it to be convenient to take not only these, but also a bunch of tools with me at the same time. Now, I have all of my tools in these Bosch boxes. I often take this one with me if I want to take a drill and some other stuff. So to connect this box to this one, we're going to use the one part in this entire build that I haven't designed myself. And that is these little attachment hooks that go into the bottom of the boxes here. It works! This is super convenient! But now, what if you only want to take one of these with you? Well, I've got a solution for that too. So, I've made a couple of these, which also are some brackets that will snap into the side of the Bosch boxes. And these guys will go on the side there. So that now, you can take one of these with you. Now, granted, this system isn't entirely perfect. You kind of have to decide whether or not you want the big box with the two assortment cases like this, or if you want the one assortment case with the holders like that. Because the side holders on this thing now make it too big to fit in the drawer there. But hey, at least now you have options. On this one, you could also attach some wheels, so you can have it as a little cart that can roll around with all your tools on top. Now, in case you want to build one of these, or all of them for that matter, for yourself, I'll have links to where you can download all the plans that I use to build these. That includes all the measurements for the wooden parts, as well as all the 3D files for all the 3D printed parts. I'll have that available to download in the link right below that like button. Now, I'll also make sure to include the 3D files for a bunch of different sizes of this grid that goes in the bottom of the assortment cases so that you can customize to whatever size drawer or box that you want to make. I'll also make sure to include all the different sizes of these assortment bins. That's everything from 1x1 all the way up to 2x6, and even a 2x8. Now, all of these will still fit with the old assortment boxes in case you've already printed a bunch of those, but the old ones that are bigger than 1x1s unfortunately won't fit anymore if you have this grid in the bottom of the drawer. Also, since I've gotten a couple of comments from my last assortment bin video that these have slightly weird sizes, and that is true, that is because I made these to fit my already existing drawers that I had made in my work table here. But to make it a little bit easier for you, if you choose to download the files for these boxes, I'll make sure to include both this size and a size that is completely square for the grid that these all fit in. Because the way mine are designed, they will only fit one way and not 90 degrees to that. It's just a slightly different size. But in the other version, they'll fit both ways. Also, quick tip if you want to print the old boxes is that you can just scale them in whatever slicer program you use to be whatever size you want. All right, so I feel like that pretty much sums up this video. I kind of want to make a whole bunch of these now in all sorts of different colors for these printed parts. I think that could look really good. Also, let me know what you think. Do you prefer the wooden colored one or do you prefer the black one? And which one of them should I go for if I choose to make a whole bunch more of these? Let me know in the comments down below. So I guess that will be it for this video. Thank you so much for watching. Make sure to subscribe if you're not yet and ring that bell so you get notified every time I upload something new. As for now, thank you so much for watching and I'll see you guys in the next video. I'm gonna start printing a whole bunch more of these boxes so I can replace all the ones in my drawers here. Wish me luck.